Yo, what's happening, class? How you guys doing, man? It's a Wednesday. It's middle of the week, and I'm going to go over the answers, all right? So go ahead and pause the video and just check if you're doing it right. Then repause it and continue the listening or hearing, listening to the answer. All right, so here we go. So we got equal value method. So again, we got, they're both of the equations are equal to y. So I'm going to set both of the expressions. Both of the expressions equal to each other. So I'm going to put 7x minus 5 equals negative 2x plus 15. I'm going to draw the line. Okay, so I'm actually looking for x. So what am I going to do first? I can't multiply, I can't add these two together. Same on the other side. So I'm going to do what's called opposites, which is zero pairs. So I'm going to go ahead and pick negative 7x. I like doing the x's, the variables first, the terms with the variables. So negative 7x. So what I did is I did the opposite over here. So on this side, I got to do the t-chart. Okay, so then what happens? This becomes zero. Drop it down. Negative 5 equals negative 2x minus 7x. So negative 2x, and then we got negative 7x, which gives you negative, and there's 9x's. So negative 9x. All right, and then we're going to drop the 15. Drop it like it's hot. Woohoo! Then I want to do a zero pair on this side because I want to isolate the variable. So I need to get rid of the 15 minus 15. Okay. So I did opposites on this side. So on this side, I got to do my little t-chart. All right. So the negative 5, negative 15. And my answer is negative what? Yeah, negative 20. Very good. Very good. Equals, oh no, there's a fraction. I didn't want a fraction, you guys. I messed up. But it's okay. Let's just work it out. Divide by negative 9. Divide by negative 9. And then x is positive. Negative divided by negative 20 over 9. And that's my x. All right? So then what is mine? Let's just work it out and let's see what we get. I didn't want to give you a fraction. But it's all good. It's all good. Why is that? It's all good because... Yeah. Here we go. Because it's Wednesday. So let's do plug it in here. Okay. Who do you think you are? Yeah. So that's... We're going to go ahead and plug it in here. So y... In order to get y, I'm going to multiply 7 times 20 over 9. All right, which is over 1, okay, minus 5. So what's 20 times, that's 140. 20 times 7 is 140, divided by 9, and then I'm going to take away 5. So 140 divided by 9. Well, I'm going to do it on the side. 140 divided by 9, that's 1. I'm going to get a fraction. That's fine. 9, so that's 50. So 9 times 7. That's 6, 5, it's 45, and then I'm going to put 0.5. So 15.5, okay? So that's fine. Oh, my goodness. I messed up there. 20 over 9 is my x, and 15.5, all right? And then 20 over 9 is about, what, 2 point something? And then 0.5. Use your calculator. Sorry about that. Oh, man. Okay, here we go. I don't know what happened. All right, let's do the next one. All right, here we go. They're both equal to y, so we're going to set it up together. All right. So then what happens here? Okay, I want to get rid of the x's, right? Let's try the x's. So minus 3x, minus 3x. That gives me 0, 0. Wait, so negative 1 is equal to x? No, this is a 0. So does negative 1 equal 0? No. So my answer is what? Well, what do you think it is? Yeah, no solution. No solution. So these two lines will not intersect. They will not cross. Okay? All right, let's try this one. All right. So now both, what is this here? Oh, it's a banana. Oh, I'm sorry. So both of these are equal to x's, right? So let's go ahead and set up the expression. 2y minus 3 is equal to 4y plus 3. All right? That's it. Oldies. All right, here we go. So here, Mr., let's get rid of the y's because they're on both sides. So we want to put them on one side. So let's do opposites. All right, I'm going to do minus 2y. So I'm going to do the opposite here. This side, I got to do the t-chart. All right? So minus 2y, that's negative 3 is equal to what's 4y minus 2y is 2y plus 3. Now I want to isolate the variable. So I'm going to do minus 3 on both sides. Okay? So I'm going to do opposites here. But then I got to do the t-chart on the other side. So what do we get? Boom, ba-ba-da-bop. So then we get negative 6, right? So negative 6 equals 2y. You might not have, now I could divide. Divide by the coefficient, which is 2. So y is equal to, 6 divided by 2 is 3. And negative divided by positive is a negative. So there's my x. No, there's my y. So my y is here, 3. Negative 3, sorry. And then my x, I could just plug it into whichever. Okay, which one do you want to use? Left or right? Left or right? Which one? Ah, if you picked right, you got it. I'm going to use the right. Oh, man. So x is equal to 4 times negative 3 plus 3. So what's 4 times negative 3? That's negative 12 plus 3. I'm going to do the t-chart again. So that's negative 12 and positive 3. Who won? Negative. By how many? Well, they won by 9. Negative 9. All right. Oh, but you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and do the next one, all right? I'm gonna do the next one too, over here. Here we go.
Can you see?
Can you see? Here we go. Multiply. Negative 6 minus 3. T-chart. My answer. How many? Yeah, negative 9. Negative 9. Negative 9, people. So what's your answer, your solution? So that's your answer right there. And the last one. Again, they're both equal to x. So I'm going to set the expression together. All right. Set it up. Set it up. Bam. There you go. Now we need to, what, solve for y. Boom. Here we go. Zero pairs. Because I cannot add negative 4y plus 7 because 7 does not have a y. Or if I take out the y, then I could add them. Okay? That's why it's called combined like terms. Right now, they're not like each other. Right? That has a y. That doesn't have a y. That has a y, and that doesn't. I mean, a y, and that doesn't. Okay? So now let's take care of the y's. All right? Let's always try to do variables first. All right? Here we go. Here we go. So I'm going to do opposite on this side. I could do plus 4y. If I do opposite here, I got to do t-chart over here, okay? Plus 4y. So we're going to have 7 equals, now 2y plus, oh, that's easy. 2y plus 4y, that's positive 6y minus 5. Now I need to isolate the variable over here, right? So I need to get rid of the what? Yes, the negative 5 opposite, and then the T chart over here, the T chart. So here we go. So what do we put? It's a bright sunshiny Wednesday. It's gonna be hot. It's gonna be a hot weekend. Don't go to the beach, you guys. Don't go. Okay? You gotta be. And then that's 7 plus 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then I'm gonna divide by 6, right? The coefficient. And then y is what? Y is what? Yeah! Y is 2. Y is 2, 2, 2, 2. There you go. Now, we're almost done. So which one do you want? Left or right? Left or right? Bam! I'm gonna use the left. So x equals negative 4 times y, which is 2, plus 7. So negative 4 times 2 is negative 8 plus 7. The t-chart, plug it in. Here we go. Negative 8 plus 7. Negative wins by how many? Yeah, they won by 1. Negative 1. Well, let's check this one out. All right, let's check it out. Here we go. X equals 2 times 2 minus 5. X equals 2 times 2 is 4. 4 minus 5. Let's do the t-chart. 4 is positive. Negative 5. Negative wins by how many? By 1. There you go. So what's your answer? Your answer is x is negative 1 and your y is 2. And bam, there's your point of what? Yes, intersection. All right, guys, that's it. I only gave you 4. All right? That's it. Woo! All right, that's it. It's Wednesday. Take it easy. Have a beautiful day. All right, I got it. It's Wednesday. Coronavirus. Coronavirus. Boom, boom, boom.